All right, back at it with Sectaurs. This time we are looking at Pinsor and Battle Beetle. Let's take a look at this thing and see how it stands up, because, boy, I don't remember him at all. All right, next on the Hodgepodge Channel. YouTube Nation, and welcome back for yet another vintage toy review. Today we are looking at Sectaurs, and this time we're looking at Pinsor with Battle Beetle. I have no recollection of this guy. Now, I have a big recollection of these guys. These were the selling point for me in this line. Not the cartoon, not comics, not anything else. This was a fun playability toy thing to look at. So we're going to dive into that as well. First up, let's just kind of kick him to the side and let's take a look at the Sectaurs, Warriors of Symbionts, Pinsor and Battle Beetle. It kind of looks to me at first, going to give a little backstory and then just a normal comic thing that goes on. I don't know why I didn't come. A little Nora Jones there. I do not know why comics came with everything. Maybe it's just they needed something to sell, or it was a Marvel character of DC. I don't know. I don't know what that was. I do love seeing this advertisement here. Just real cool to see. I would like to get all of this at some point. I had the Hive at one point, just the shell. It's a big turd, but maybe I'll change my mind once I get everything. But, I mean, to have everything there and to have your advertisements within the comic, that's a smart move and a very good job. So I dig that. So Pinsor, mine is not complete. He does have his shield, which I think looks very cool and does look very like holdable for some kind of claw thing here. We're going to talk about his hands here in a second. I'm missing his axe, and I believe he came with a blaster. So mine's not complete, but it's good enough for me. Let's take a look at Pinsor first. He's kind of like a chonker, kind of a fat-bellied claw-looking thing. I don't like how his hands are. It almost makes me feel as if his hands are on backwards, like this one should be over here to look like that. It does make me feel like they messed up the wrists, because they just look wonky. If I want him to hold his shield, it's got to kind of be like this, which I'm not a fan. I mean, it looks fine once it's there, and I don't know. The wrists and the arms look weird. I do like the shimmering effect of it. I do like the fact he came with his sword. At least I got one accessory. I'm not going to rank that out because it's just a sword. But really, what we want for this guy to do is to ride this. Now, this Battle Beetle looks really cool. It's got arms that'll come in and out that'll attack. And if you'll see down here, this is the moving mechanism that makes that happen. You pull it down and they attack. This is for you to just hold to kind of make it fly. Now, the cool thing is it comes with this glove. We're going to try it. Why not? We're going to see if my hand will go in. All right, so, my pretty. So hand does go in, hand goes in everything. So, I mean, this is, if I'm an adult, I mean, that's kind of cool playability to be able to have. It's not much on the, I mean, really, it's just kind of like a coming at you. It's kind of uncomfortable as an adult. I hope it doesn't get stuck on me. I do like the fact that my glove is completely good. And it does black glove for the playability. They were thinking about it. And the character looks good. It does have some like fake faux real fur on the back that it kind of bucks and goes. And he's loose in the legs, as you can see, kind of like that. But of course he is, because you want him on the saddle. You want your characters to be on this beetle and going as such. It's for me, thinking of playability right now as a kid, it would be hard to have your hand in that, because you'd only have one. I mean, I guess unless you have two hands going at it, these would be hard to battle if you had your hands in two of them. But, man, it looks cool. Sectaurs are an underrated, and I've given them crap for years. Even when I used to do the podcast with Glenn on Back to the 80s, and I did toy reviews even more as Wheelbreaker 41 back in the day. I mean, I gave these things crap, but they I don't know why right now they're kind of got a place in my heart to where I love them. Again, not complete, but it is fun to look at these guys. They are really good looking. They're going to look good on a shelf, and I got a comic, and they look good just kind of hanging out there. As you can see the G.I. Joe stuff that's happened. Here's my checklist sheet. So for my checklist sheet for Sectaurs, there's not a lot of them. There's four beasts, there's one playset, and there's five figures. So what is that? 10 total things. So I'm 20% done. Love it. All right. Well, until next time, hope everybody enjoyed this. Peace out, Home Skillets, and give Sectaurs some love. They need it. Peace out.